Welcome back to The Big Show. I'm your host, Joel Nunez, and to start things off, here's a food idea.
Hey guys, so today we're going to be making spaghetti tacos, commonly seen on iCarly, and this is what you need. So apparently if it sticks, then it's done. So, all right, we're good. Let's get them out of there. Everything is all finished. All we have to do is put out our tacos and fill them up, and we will see how that goes. Alright, so today we're here with Video Production, and they are going to be trying our spaghetti tacos.
Smells good.
Thoughts?
Very good,
very flavorful. Yeah, that's right.
Who would have thought we could blend Italian and Mexican cuisine? Only on PHS TV.
That's right, you heard it here first.
We have so many questions and a lot of students. So we asked, here's Ask Patriot.
Hey, Kermit the Frog here.
So if we were friends, what would our handshake be? Alright, I like that. Manly. Alright, if we were friends, what would our handshake be? Just like that? Damn. Alright, cool. So we're gonna go like this one? And then. Alright, cool. If y'all were friends, just saying, what would your guys' handshake be? That was clean. Hey. Hey, Miss Hickman. Miss Hickman. Miss Hickman. Miss Hickman. Miss Hickman. Miss Hickman. If we were friends, what would our handshake be?
Hello, everyone. I want to give a special shout out to someone. You mean the world to me. We've had so many fun memories ever since we became friends, and even now as a couple. I want to share many more with you, Sophie. And if you want to have an unforgettable night, look to your left.
There's many untold mysteries in history. Here's Mysteries of History.
Why Friday the 13th is unlucky? Let's do this. We're all familiar with the idea that Friday the 13th is bad luck. I mean, heck, even some hotels skip the 13th floor on the elevator buttons just for this reason. But why? The origin of this superstition is unclear, but the first noted references showed up around the mid-19th century. A US Army captain named William Fowler founded the 13 Club, a group of 13 men in New York with an aim to prove superstitions false. They gathered for the first time on Friday the 13th, 1881, and their club activities included things like walking under ladders and breaking mirrors. Sign me up, because that sounds like fun. Donald Dossey, a folklore historian, suggests that the bad vibes associated with Friday the 13th have roots in ancient history. The number 13 has a shade of misfortune in Nordic mythology, as well as cultural and religious history. In numerology, the study of the symbolism of numbers, 12 stands for completeness, and the 13 is thought of as odd or out of place. It's simply an uncomfortable number. The origins of the unluckiness of Friday as a day are a little bit fuzzier. The name Friday was chosen to honor the Norse goddess Frigg, aka Freya. She was the goddess of love, beauty, wisdom, war, death, and magic. This day was considered to be extremely unlucky for weddings, and later on, the Christian church attempted to demonize the goddess, which also may be a factor in that day's bad luck. With all of those factors added in, it's no wonder people think this day is unlucky.
Yeah. We love to talk about random things. Here's Chatterbox.
Welcome to Chatterbox, the only TV talk show that is not fake whatsoever. Now, WrestleMania just passed, which brings up the worldwide question. Wrestling, it's fake. Why should we care?
Wrestling's not fake. In the hearts of many children, they feel like it's real.
But all these punches, all these slams, It had to be fake. Come on, throwing them off the ladder, going off the steel cage, why should
that hurts, going off the ladder, being thrown off a cage?
To prove his point, we have a wrestler today, just coming out of WrestleMania. Give it up for the WWE Champion,
The Hunchback!
Now, hold up. Why should we care? Wrestling is fake.
No, it's not.
Obviously.
No, it's
obviously.
Not. Look, I wanna... Now...
Are you okay?
He learned his lesson. This is not fake. So...
Had enough of you. Breaking news, our former host Joseph has been injured by the Hunchback. He has now sustained critical damage and is in the hospital waiting treatment.
Sorry. But I'm here. Come back next week for another Chatterbox.
Here's BHS Cypher.
Don't like, no. Sneak the signs, that's. Don't like, no. Don't like, like. Don't like. A snitch.
Introducing the new Apple iPerson, complete with multi-touch and volume control. Doesn't it feel good to touch? Doesn't it feel good to touch? Doesn't it feel good to touch? My world is so digital that I have forgotten what that feels like. It used to be hard to connect when friends formed cliques, but it's even more difficult to connect now that cliques form friends. But who am I to judge? I face Facebook more than books face me, hoping to book face-to-faces. I update my status, 420 space to prove I'm still breathing. Failure to do this daily means my whole web-wide world will forget that I exist. But with 3,000 friends online, only 5 I can count in real life. Why wouldn't I spend more time in the world where there are more people that like me? Wouldn't you? Here, it doesn't matter if I'm an amateur person as long as I have a profile. My smile is 50% genuine and 50% genuine HD. You would need Blu-rays to read the whites of my teeth, but I'm not that focused. 10 tabs open, hoping my problems can be resolved with a 1600 by 1700 revolution. This is a problem with this evolution doubled over. We used to sit in treetops till we swung down to stand upright, then someone slipped a disc. Now we're doubled over at desktops. From the Garden of Eden to the branches of Macintosh, apple picking has always come at a great cost. iPod, iMac, iPhone, iChat. I can do all of these things without making eye contact. We used to sprint. We used to sprint to pick and store blackberries. Now we run to the sprint store to pick blackberries. It's scary. I can't hear the sound of Mother Nature speaking over all that tweeting. And along with it is our ability to feel as it's fleeting. You would think these headphone jacks inject in the flesh the way we connect the disconnect power on. So we get power less. They got us love drugged like e-pills. So we e-trade, email, emotion like e-commerce, because now money can buy love for $9.95 a month. Click to proceed to check out. Click to X out where our hearts once were. Click, I've uploaded this hug. I hope she gets it. Click, I'm making love to my wife. I hope she's logged in. Click, I'm holding my daughter over a Skype conference call while she's crying in the crib in the next room. Click, so when my phone goes off on my hip, I touch and I touch and I touch, because in a world where there are voices that are only read and laughter is never heard, I'm so desperate to feel that I hope the technology can reverse the universe until the screen can touch me back. And maybe it will when our technology is advanced enough to make us human again.
We all tend to mess up. No one's perfect. Here's some bloopers.
Patriot has a lot of new ways to get creative. Dude, you just moved it. What's new? What's popping with the new rap? Coming to you from Studio B with Cypher.
You said it wrong.
I know. It's so slow.
Okay, here we go. Thank you. Hey! 0 to 1.
Use your car to the
baseball against Ramona away on Tuesday at 3:15. And oh my gosh. Thursday against Ramona as well at 3:15. Never mind that. Softball has a game against Ramona away on Tuesday and home on Thursday.
No.
Come on. What? I go with it with. Oh my gosh.
Go!
Okay, we'll start this over again.
Tennis, 2-2 in league. They have a game against Ramona.
This is the wackest sports update ever.
Alright, then you come do it.
No.
Alright,
you then. Do it. Shh,
stop talking.
I got the degrees. You stop talking.
I'm not getting a degree. Tennis is 2-2 in league. Someone's cut. Interrupting when I'm trying to cut.
That's a cut. Someone.
Try again. There you go. Yeah, try again tomorrow.
Bro. Patriot, this week on weather, it's going to be in the upper.
Up in the. That's not my line.
Say something about
there's so many games and scores. Like.
Just say March Madness is going on in sports. Be sure to keep tuned to your favorite college. Basketball team.
All right.
Make it general. Yeah, go.
We have
March Madness going
on. Why not say it?
We have March Madness going on. Make sure you tune into your favorite college basketball team to see what happens.
You know this is going on Friday.
Stop that.
8, 7.
Stop that. Good. And that is all we have for today. Thanks for watching. Be sure to tune in on Monday for what you need to know.